In this video, we look at the effectiveness NTU method for heat exchanger calculations. Let's first look at the context of the performance problem for heat exchangers, which we introduced in an earlier video. In the performance problem, only the inlet temperatures and flow rates are known. That is, in the case of a parallel flow exchanger, you know m dot. We know the hot fluid inlet, cold fluid inlet, and the area is known, but we don't know the outlet temperature of either fluid, neither it is a desired variable. So, but the area is known. What do we mean by area is known? It means that the heat exchanger is readily available. It could be an off-shelf heat exchanger. There are different heat exchangers that are available, and you have to select one among them. Or there is an existing heat exchanger which you want to repurpose it and use it for something else. So in both the cases, the area is known and the inlet temperatures are known. Only what you don't know is the outlet temperature. Now, unlike the LMTD method, we cannot do an energy balance to get an outlet temperature, because you need to know at least one temperature to find the energy balance of the other temperature. So we cannot use an energy balance to determine the outlet temperature now. So for that purpose, this class of problem is known as a performance evaluation. That is, you are evaluating that what will be the heat rate that is available for this. So if you know the heat rate, obviously you can use the energy balance and find the outlet temperature. Or if you know the outlet temperature, you can finding the outlet temperature is also called as the finding the performance. How much can you heat up the cold fluid? So in this case, we define what is known as, firstly, the maximum heat transfer that is possible. To find what is the available heat rate, we define a theoretical concept of maximum heat rate. So what is a maximum heat rate? We saw in the LMTD method that the counter flow arrangement has the maximum Q for a given area. Now the maximum Q, how is it achieved? Consider a parallel flow in which the cold side fluid has got a steeper than the hot side thing. So in this case, when does the maximum heat transfer occurs? Maximum heat transfer occurs when at some point this outlet temperature of the cold fluid reaches the inlet temperature of the hot fluid. That means after this area, it's a very large area, after this area, there is no longer possibility of transferring heat from here to here, because these both have become equal. So that defines our maximum heat rate. So let us consider two cases in which the first case, the hot fluid has got a lower slope compared to the cold fluid. In this case, the hot fluid has got a higher slope compared to the cold fluid. How is this achieved? For this, we just need to go and look back at our differential energy balance. In differential energy balance, we saw that the heat coming from the hot fluid, mcp delta T of the hot fluid, goes to mcp delta T of the cold fluid. So given this background, and this is the requirement, it means that if DTH is less than DTC, DTH is less than DTC, then CH has to be greater than CC. CH, to recall, is nothing but MCP into CP, that is MCP of hot fluid. This is MCP of the cold fluid. So if the blue slope has to be higher, then the red specific heat rate has to be higher. Similarly, if the red slope has to be higher, then CH should be less than CC. The opposite dependence from here. Then at an infinite X, this outlet temperature of the cold fluid will approach the inlet temperature of the hot fluid. Similarly, in this case, if CH is less than CC, the outlet temperature of the hot fluid will approach the inlet temperature of the cold fluid. Therefore, we can calculate Q max now. Q max based on the cold fluid is CC times cold out minus cold in. But cold out approaches THI. So Q max is nothing but CC times cold out, which is nothing but THI. So THI minus T cold inlet. In this case, Q max is nothing but the hot fluid CH, THI inlet minus outlet. But the outlet approaches TCI. Outlet approaches TCI, so we replace that by TCI. So it is CH times THI minus THI, TCI. So notice that in both the cases, this factor is common. It is THI minus TCI, THI minus TCI. Both are given variables. Only that in this particular case, it is CC. In this particular, it is CH. So the generic formula for Q max, the theoretical maximum heat transfer that is possible, is C min. Okay. What is C min? That is the minimum of these both. In this particular case, where CH is greater than CC, we get the Q max in terms of CC. Here CC is minimum of these both, which is CC is the smaller value. So this is C min is CC. So C min is the minimum of CH and CC. In this particular case, again, it is CH. CH is smaller than CC. So the generic formula for a theoretical maximum heat transfer rate is Q max is C min times THI minus TCI. Now we can define the term called as effectiveness epsilon. This effectiveness epsilon is the actual heat transfer for a given area and temperature to the maximum possible heat transfer. The maximum possible is what we just derived, which is Q max. And what is achievable now is for a given area. This is at infinite area, but this at a finite area, you get Q. So this Q by Q max is your effectiveness or epsilon. So we can show that in the case, the way we defined Q max is nothing but C min times THI minus TCI. And if you write Q in terms of the cold fluid, actual heat transfer for the cold fluid, then it is CC times outlet of cold fluid minus inlet of cold fluid. Or if you write in terms C, hot fluid heat capacity, then it is CH times THI, which is hot side, which is hotter than the outlet. Inlet is hotter than the outlet. So it is THI minus THO. A second concept that we need to define is called as the number of transfer units or NTU. NTU is defined, is a dimensionless number, which is defined as the ratio of conductance, that is U times A, to the minimum heat capacity rate, which is C min. These both are of the same units. Therefore, this is a dimensionless number. Now, why is it called a number of transfer unit? What is a transfer unit? So one transfer unit or one NTU is, the meaning of that can be understood by multiplying this side by this. So you have one NTU. And where do we have these expressions coming together? It is C min times delta T. Okay. C min times delta T is UA delta T. Now, this delta T is different from this delta T. What is this delta T? This is the bulk heating of a liquid. So in this case, if it is C min, let's say the cold fluid is having this minimum, this one here. In for this, we call it as delta T max, because in this, for a given change in area, temperature is maximum for the cold fluid. So we saw that these are inversely related. Wherever C is min, delta T change is maximum. So C min times delta T max is here, and UA times delta T is on the right hand side. Whereas this delta T is the temperature difference along this steeper stream, whereas this delta T is the difference between the hot fluid and cold fluid. So coming back to the meaning interpretation of NTU, NTU, that is one transfer unit, is the area at which delta T max equal to delta T. So if this change of the temperature of the hot fluid or the cold fluid is same as the temperature difference in the between the hot fluid and cold fluid, then that area at which this is achieved is called as a one transfer unit. So as the transfer unit increases, so you go to infinite transfer unit, so this is like one transfer unit. So if you keep on increasing the area at infinite transfer unit, this will approach the inlet, or the effectiveness factor will approach one. There are relationships between effectiveness factor and the NTU which can be derived. In the case of parallel flow with cold stream having the steeper temperature gradient, we have C min as the CH. So because the cold stream is having steeper temperature gradient, C min will be the hot stream's heat capacity rate. So we in this case, the actual heat transfer rate is outlet minus inlet of hot fluid divided by THI minus TCA, which is the effectiveness factor which we defined before. And this can be derived to be of this form, where in this expression, we have NTU, which comes on the right hand side. NTU is nothing but UA by C min. So that comes. And then we also have CR, which is nothing but the ratio of C min to C max. So this is a relationship of epsilon as a function of NTU and CR. We can invert this and also write NTU as a function of epsilon and CR. So we have two functions here, epsilon as a function of NTU and CR, or NTU as a function of epsilon and CR. So these are available for various configurations of heat exchangers, for single pass, multi-pass, and so on. Now, what is the use of this? The use of this epsilon NTU method is in the performance calculation. Again, performance means we have the inlet temperatures and flow rate and the area, but we need to find the outlet temperatures. How it is done? The first step is to do calculate the NTU. Because area is known, we can calculate UA by C min. C min is also known from here. So once NTU is calculated, you can use this function or a chart or a table to find the effectiveness. So effectiveness only requires NTU and CR. CR is again C min by C max. So because CR is and NTU are known, we can find effectiveness. Once effectiveness is known, because effectiveness is Q by Q max, we can also find Q. And if Q is known, then we can use the energy balance to determine outlet cold temperature or outlet hot temperature. Epsilon NTU method can also be used for design calculation. In design calculation, we had used LMTD method, but you can also use the epsilon NTU method. In this design calculations, as we saw before, all the four temperatures are known or easily calculatable, but the area is not known. So area has to be found out from these four temperatures. So in this case, we first evaluate epsilon and not NTU. So because we know the temperatures, we know the actual Q, and we know the theoretical Q max. So epsilon can be calculated. So once epsilon is calculated, we can use the inverse relationship between NTU and epsilon, that is epsilon and C min by C max are known, and we can calculate NTU. So once NTU is calculated, from the relation definition of NTU, which is UA by C min, area can be calculated. To summarize the effectiveness NTU method, effectiveness is the actual heat rate by the maximum or theoretical possible heat rate. And NTU was defined as the conductance to the heat capacity rate. And epsilon and NTU can be, relationship between epsilon and NTU can be obtained for various configurations. Charts and tables are available. And using that relationship, we can use to calculate both the performance, which is the outlet temperatures or heat rate, and design in which you find out the area. Thank you.